What's up, everybody? My name is Dwight, and welcome back to GeForce Garage. Today, we're building a small form factor PC powered by a GeForce RTX 4080 Super. SFF builds are becoming a more popular choice for DIY gamers, and we've done our fair share of them with the last three generations, like the GTX 1070 LAN box, the RTX SFF PC powered by a 2060, and the RTX 3070 build. Sometimes it can be quite challenging when it comes to ensuring clearance for all the hardware, because GeForce cards come in all shapes and sizes. Dropping in a high-end GPU is usually a no-brainer in an ATX case, but if you're building in a small form factor PC, it's a bit more difficult. The end result is diving deep into spec tables and having to account for every available millimeter, but it doesn't have to be complicated. So we've worked with industry partners to develop a guideline for graphics cards and small form factor case compatibility, called the SFF-Ready Enthusiast GeForce Cards and Compatible Cases. You'll start to see more and more compatible products being listed in the ecosystem. Today we'll be using a GeForce card and a case compatible with the guidelines to show you that it's easier than ever to build a high-performance PC in a small footprint. Here are the components we'll be using for our SFF build. We're going to be starting with the ASUS ProArt GeForce RTX 4080 Super. This 2.5 slot powerhouse is just 300 millimeters long and fully compliant with the new SFF Ready guideline. We'll be pairing it with a 14th gen Intel i7 on an ASUS ROG STRIX B760 ITX motherboard. To be economic with our space, we got some low profile G.Skill Flare RAM sticks, two of them totaling 64 gigs, and a ton of storage with a 4 TB Samsung M.2. We'll be building in a Cooler Master NCORE 100 Max, which has a compact footprint of 6.1 inches by 8.3 inches, and is just 16 liters in volume, most of which is in height. Another thing about this case, it comes with its own custom AIO, which should keep our i7 nice and cool, and an 850 watt power supply. While it does already have custom length cables, we will be swapping out the 12 volt high power for a fully sleeved one from Cable Mod. This build is going to pack a lot of horsepower into a compact footprint, so let's get to building. Well, there you have it. It is all done and put together. I actually really liked working inside this case. I mean, there's not a whole lot of room for cable management, but it works out because most of the cables are short, so it all kind of tucks away nicely. I do really like how big the GPU side of this case is. I think we actually have a little bit more wiggle room to get even a bigger GPU in there if we wanted to. Now let's install a couple of games on it and see how well it performs.
We're gonna start off with Alan Wake 2 at 4K resolution, graphics set to very high with full ray tracing and DLSS 3.5, we're sitting at around 85 to 95 FPS. Over in Cyberpunk at max settings again at 4K with full ray tracing and DLSS 3.5 turned on, I saw around 70 to 75 FPS on average. And lastly, over in Horizon Forbidden West at 4K, settings at very high with DLSS 3, we stayed around 135 frames per second.
I have a soft spot for small form factor builds, especially those that make good use of the vertical space. Big shout out to ASUS for providing the GPU. I love that it matches the bronze color of this case. If you guys enjoyed this episode and would like to see more, hit that subscribe button down below, and I'll see you for the next one.